Okay, hello cloud gurus, how y'all doing? I'm Scott Pletcher here with another round of AWS News goodness. This week we get something resembling a proper firewall for our VPCs, Amazon Personalize gets more personable, and Amazon DocumentDB with MongoDB compatibility gets more compatible. Plus, we'll reveal the guru of the week right here on AWS This Week. Recently, AWS announced the availability of the AWS Network Firewall, a fully managed network firewall designed to help protect those important subnet resources. Now, of course, we've had security groups, network ACLs, web application firewalls, and AWS Shield, and we still have those things. But AWS Network Firewall aims to be an easier and more functional way to control traffic going in and out of our VPCs, you know, like a real firewall. You'll need to create a network firewall in each AZ that you want to protect, and they can be configured to do firewall things, like allow, deny, and drop certain traffic based on IP and protocol. But they can also do more advanced things, like inspect packets for pattern matching or restrict certain domains for outbound traffic. They can also support Suricata IPS rules syntax, which allows for some quite complex threat detection rules. Do know that this nifty service will cost you though based on runtime and the amount of network traffic processed. The curiously named Amazon DocumentDB with MongoDB compatibility has gotten some new capabilities as part of its adoption of MongoDB 4.0 compatibility. One such feature that Amazon DocumentDB with MongoDB compatibility is particularly proud of is the ability to perform transactions across documents. Now, many of you may be saying, so what? Well, Amazon DocumentDB with MongoDB compatibility is considered a NoSQL database. And generally, NoSQL databases adhere to what's called a base consistency model. That just means that it's okay for the updates to lag behind a tiny bit across the database in exchange for much better performance and scalability. In comparison, relational databases usually adhere to what's called an ACID consistency model. Now, without getting too much into the weeds, this just means that the database handles updates in a very complete and deliberate way, a transactional way, with consistency taking priority over performance and record availability. Now, different scenarios call for different consistency models. A common use cases for ACID consistency models are order processing, inventory systems, or financial transactions, where you'd want to be sure only the most recent updated values can be retrieved. Now that Amazon DocumentDB with MongoDB compatibility supports transactions, we can leverage both consistency models where appropriate. Amazon Personalize users can now use dynamic filters to generate recommendations. Now, if you use Personalize, this is certainly a very welcome improvement, as you can now define filters that accept a parameter you can just pass in, versus having to create a bunch of hard-coded filters to cover all the possible options. Now, there is a caveat in that only in and equal operators support dynamically passing in values into the filters. You still need to use static filters if you're trying to use a range query, such as greater than or less than. And now on to the coveted guru of the week. This week's deserving winner is Elliot Jennings, intrepid software engineer and devoted Fulham FC fan from London in the UK. A fancy swag pack is on its way to you as I speak. If you'd like to test your cloud expertise, head on over to this week's question linked down below. And remember, winners are selected not just based on correctness of the answer, but also in your reasoning and depth of thought reflected in your response. Now, go impress those judges. That, my friends, is all the AWS news that's fit to print this week. Stay safe, take care of one another, and keep being awesome, cloud gurus.